Welcome to Ultimate League, Week 5, Season 3. I'm Bilal and it looks like I've got the job permanently now. Moving on to the first game, Heaton and Salford visited MFC. This was a derby game between two teams that knew each other well, and both teams were desperate to win this one. Riz was finally telling us he had his full team for this game, but of course, we can never be sure. Heaton and Salford are yet to score a goal, but are playing some excellent football, particularly star man Jamie, who is one of the most skillful players in the league. The game was played at a good pace, but it was the captain Riz Malik who scored with a screamer. But we've been known to do the impossible like Broadway dough, so sleep if you want, like we will help you get your Z's true. But here's the real scoop. I'm all that and then some, short, dark and handsome, bust a nut inside your eye to show you where I come from. I'm vexed, fuming, I've had it up to here. Heaton and Salford fought back and equalised shortly afterwards through Captain Jawad. Heaton and Salford went close shortly after hitting the bar. Let yourself go, don't sweat what you heard, but act like you know. Yes, yes, y'all, yes, y'all, who got the vibe, it's the tribe, y'all, tribe, y'all, live, y'all, live, y'all, inside, outside, come around. Who's that? Brown. Some may I say, call me Charlie, the word is the herb, and I'm deep like Bob Marley. Lay back on the payback, evolve, rotate the gates. Contact. Can I get a hit? Hit. With a brother named Tip, and we're ready to flip. East Coast stomping, ripping and romping. New York, North Carolina, and Compton. Check it out. The loops for the troops, more
MFC took control of the game with Adji scoring three goals set up by his fellow forward Chris. The game finished 4-1, and unfortunately, two players were sent off due to abusive language, which won't be tolerated by the league. They've let their team down, and unfortunately, will miss next week's game too. Moving on to game 2, saw Baroni playing FC Iraq. We expected Baroni to come out and dominate this game and try to win to keep up the pressure on Dream Team. They started the game well, dominating the possession and had the majority of the chances. They opened the scoring midway through the first half, however they were pegged back when Jaffa scored to equalise. And we got the goods here. Yeah. Never on the left, cause my right's my good ear. Yeah. I could give a damn about an ill subliminal. Stay away from crime, so I ain't no criminal. I love my young nation, groovy sensation. No time for hibernation, only elation. Don't ever try to test. Don't want a little kid. The game was 1-1 at half time, but Iraq took the initiative in the second half with the main man Jaffa scoring a great solo effort. After this, Baroni showed some urgency and had a further few chances but were denied by some excellent goalkeeping. Eamon had a great game at the back and it looks like he's settling in well, but he was unable to prevent the equaliser which happened late on. The game finished 2-2, with both teams disappointed with the result. Iraq will look to build on this and win next week, whereas Baroni have a tough game next week playing Dream Team.
Was a very good game, end-to-end stuff. Bit disappointed to be honest that we didn't win, but got to hand it to him. They did their job well. You know, they contained us and we found it tough. I think it's a fair result in the end, fair result.
Mustafa?
Sorry? Yeah, I think to be honest they've been on fire this season, but that was their real test, the first real test. We've been playing a bit of lower teams.
but there's no point in getting points.
I've got to tell you one thing, lads. If you're going to play for FC Iraq, watch out for the Stoke City tactics. That's all it is. Peter Crouch up front, Robert Huth at the back, that's all you need to know.
Moving on to game 3, Bayern never losing against Unity. Bayern never losing are having an excellent season so far, however Unity seem to be struggling. This game saw Bayern never losing dominate from start to finish, with starman Sam once again stealing the show. He opened the scoring after being set up by Ishi, and was also trying to claim the second, but on replay it looks like it was an own goal. He did however add to his first goal after being set up by Yusuf. Bayern never losing were comfortable throughout this game and Unity looked in disarray at times. The scoring was rounded up by Ishii and John, leaving Bayern never losing joint top of the table after this 5-0 victory. Unfortunately, Unity are in the relegation battle. We've heard rumblings of disunity within the team. They're going to have to pull together though in order to get out of this relegation battle.
We went in hard, and big man Daniel's coming up the wing here. Has been playing. Was on fire today. So he was.
You know, I think it was a brilliant game. You know, it was 5-0. Great result for the team. You know, playing out wide. The play was fantastic, and Yusuf in the middle. I thought he was amazing. And our manager, credit to him, he's brought up a brilliant set of lads. And it's just a shame he can't be here to you know, enjoy this celebration with us.
We want to thank Mustafa. Unfortunately, his goldfish died, so he couldn't be with us. But I hope Barney was in a better place.
Game 4 was another massive game, TSI playing Barcelona. Unfortunately, as you may well be aware, there were technical issues and we were only able to show you bits of the second half. Barcelona dominated possession throughout the game. However, TSI scored on the break in the first half. In the second half, Barcelona pressed forward, equalising following an own goal from Zahib. TSEI responded well, and shortly after, Ify scored a superb volley. The third goal saw Yusuf score directly from a goal kick, and I'm sure Doggy will be disappointed not to have saved him. Simply Jeff the leader, base in the space means peace, see you later. Later, 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 alligator.
Pop blows a weasel and the earth's an inflator. So yo, the D, what the O, incorporated.
After this goal, TSEI were rarely troubled. However, when Barcelona did have a good opportunity, Wazzy was up for the challenge, making this superb save. Never on the left, cause my right's my good ear. I could give a damn about an ill subliminal. Stay away from crime, so I ain't no criminal. I love my young nation, groovy sensation, no time for hibernation, only Yusuf chipped in with a fourth, adding gloss to the final score. TSCI have now moved above Barcelona in the league and will look to build on their performance next week. Barcelona will now have to go back to the drawing board if they want to get back into the title race.
To be honest, I have to say, I don't know what to say. Dumbfounded. Shouldn't have lost the game. We dominated, conceded sloppy goals. There's nothing you can do. Goals make the game. Goals is how you win games.
So what are you going to do next week then?
We'll come back. We'll keep trying. We'll keep plugging away. But right now, our confidence is low. We need to get confidence back. And
keep the hard work, lads.
Thank you.
Good luck next week.
Unfortunately, as you know, there were technical issues and we are not able to show the footage from the other two big games. JJGK and Manchester's Finest had a close game, with both sides having chances, though these were few and far between. Manchester's Finest did score late on through Shaft, with the front man scoring a diving header after Faz's cross. The final game saw underdogs face up against Dream Team. Everyone expected Dream Team to continue their run in the league, but nobody mentioned this to underdogs. They opened the scoring after a great goal from Ali Raza, and Dream Team were not at their best in this one. There were times when tempers flared and their frustration showed. Underdog scored a second goal by Sahil, and in the second half, Zeeshan scored directly from a corner. There was some controversy at the time whether this had gone directly in, but the footage that was seen by myself at the time, which showed it was a clear goal. Dream Team were frustrated and angry at this decision, and vented this in the wrong way to the referee. This resulted in two players being sent off, and the game was subsequently abandoned. Unfortunately for Dream Team, these two players will miss the game next week against Baroni. But once again, we want to emphasise that no abuse will be tolerated towards the referees, other players and staff. Next week will be another big week for Ultimate League, and we hope the football continues to do the talking.
Dream Team said they'll do the talking on the pitch. What do you have to say to them?
I didn't hear them on the pitch at all.
Yeah.
I think it was a clean sheet we got,
actually. Yeah. That kind of fantastic.
I'm sure they walked off.
Could handle
them,
could handle them.
Ask the referee how to talk, he'll
deal with it. Top goal scorer in the league is Bob Risby. How did he manage to keep a clean sheet against him?
Basically, I had him in my pocket.
Oh, did you have him just there?
Next week, I'll let him out and you guys can play again.
Apologies for the delay, but we can now finally show you highlights for Week 2, Division 2 of the Ultimate League. The summary so far, this league has been very close, with several teams vying for promotion. The two teams that look most impressive are Gladiators and Super 8s, with Badiou and Mo Jammer for Gladiators and Haseeb and Bilal for Super 8 showing good promise. Here are some highlights from Week 2. Inside, outside, come around. Who's that? Brown. Some may I say, call me Charlie. The word is the herb and I'm deep like Bob Marley. Lay back on the payback, Evolve rotate the gates. Contact. Can I get a hit? Hit. Boom, bit with a brother named Tip. And we're ready to flip. East Coast stomping, ripping and romping. New York, North, Cackalacka and Compton. Check it out. The loops for the troops. More bounds to the ounce. And wow, how now, brown cow. We're ill till the skill gets down. For the flex. Here are the highlights from this week. We'll start with the big game at the top, Super 8 versus Gladiators. This game was extremely close and both teams appeared to be very even. The Super 8 scored from Captain Bilal, but at the end of the game were extremely thankful to their goalkeeper Joe, who has been tremendous all season. Gladiators play an excellent passing style and are usually clinical. However, in this game they missed many good opportunities. This victory for Super 8 saw them open up a 3-point gap at the top of the league. Gladiators will want to bounce back next week. The second game saw MIC play MAB. This game saw MIC dominate throughout the game and were worthy of their 1-0 victory. They also look impressive, and their captain Mohamed Ramadan looks like their star player. Game 3 saw Kazaki's 8 play New Stars. Kazaki's 8 haven't had a good start to the season and started the game 1-0 down for being late. They did play the better football in this game, however it finished 2-2 in the end. Let's hope Sarkis are on time for the game next week. The final game in Division 2 saw Alti Stars play Jabe. Alti Stars are yet to pick up a win and are yet to score in Ultimate League. Starman Ali Karim for Jabe scored one and assisted in another. The final score was 3-0 and Jabe also looked like an impressive team. Watch as I combine all the juice from the mind. Heal up, wheel up, bring it back, come rewind. Powerful impact, boom, from the cannon. Now bragging, try to reap a mind, just imagine. Both can't build, there is necessary. When digging into my library. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Eating I do still like the one pizza tosser. All over the track, man. Pardon me. Here's the table after this week's result. I had to beg your pardon. When I travel through the turn, I roll with the squadron. Row, row, like a dungeon dragon. Change your little jaws cause your pants are sagging. Try to step to this, I will twist you in a turban. And have it smell right like some old stale urine. And here's next week's fixtures. The rear got diesel, but cheeks they were kicking. Yo, bust it out before the buster, bust another round. The rhythm is in sync. Around the old town. Tripping up the sound just like a ratio. Observe the vibe and check out the scenario. Yo, yo, yo. Here we go, yo. So what's the scenario?